So friends, let's take our next question, that is question number 7. The question you see here belongs to section of mechanics from the chapter System of Particles. Here the moment of inertia of a body about a given axis is 1.5 kg m². Initially the body is at rest. In order to produce a rotational kinetic energy of 1200 joules, the angular acceleration of 20 rads/s² must be applied about the axis for a duration of. So we need the time for which this acceleration should be provided. So let's start with the solution. In order to know the time or duration, we have alpha, so we need omega here. So kinetic energy rotational is given by half I omega square. What is the value of kinetic energy here? That is 1200. This is half into, what is the value of I? That is 1.5 into omega square. When you solve this one, you will get omega as equals to 40 rads/s, right? Now this omega can be written as alpha t. So t would be equal to omega by alpha. What is the value of alpha? That is 20 rads/s² and omega is 40. So this answer would be 2 seconds. Let's see which is the best suited option here. So among the 4 options given to us, yes, option number 2 would be the right answer. Right, let's move on to our next segment. Here in this question, you see this belongs to section of electromagnetism. This belongs to particular chapter current electricity. The resistance of a galvanometer is 50 ohm, and the maximum current which can be passed through galvanometer is 0.002 amperes. So this is IG and this is the value of capital G, right? What resistance must be connected to it in order to convert it into an ammeter ranging from 0 to 0.5A? This is the maximum current which can be passed through the ammeter. So we have to find the value of the shunt which is to be added. You all are aware that in order to convert a galvanometer into ammeter, you have to add a shunt parallel to the galvanometer, right? In that case, let's see if this is the galvanometer. So the main current in the circuit would be I. I can pass only IG, which can be passed through here. So I will create an alternate path, that is shunt for this case. Let's take this resistance as S. So what current will pass through here is I minus IG, right? So the potential of both S and G should be equal. So I will write I small g into capital G. That would be equal to I minus IG into S, right? So here if you see, capital I is given to us as 0.5 ampere. IG is given to us as 0.002 ampere and capital G is given to us as 50 ohm, right? Let's put down the value. So this is 0.002 into 50, that is equals to 0.5 minus 0.002 into S. Solving this, S you will get as 0.2 ohm. Let's see which is the best suited option here. So among the 4, option number 1 would be our right answer, right? Now let's move on to our next question. The question number 9 you see belongs to section of modern physics. Here a helium plus ion is in its first excited state, that means electron is in second orbit, right? Its ionization energy is given by solution. So it's very easy. That would be minus of 13.6 into Z square by N square, electron volt per atom. So if you just put down the values, in this case for helium, Z is equals to 2 and N will be taken as 2. When you put down the values, you will get the value to be 13 minus 13.6 EV. This is the energy which is with the orbit, the negative energy. In order to ionize it, you have to give the same amount of energy back so that it can be liberated, and the answer would be here would be option number 1, right? Let's move on to our next question, that is question number 10.